May 18th, 2025, a high-based, discrete supercell would produce 4 highly photogenic tornadoes near Arnett, Oklahoma.
Oh my God.
From initiation to dissipation, this is my entire chasing strategy of this impressive storm.
Wow.
Time is 4:24 and we have storms initiating 25 miles to our southwest, going up in a volatile environment. Let's see what happens.
Time is 4:55.
Hello everyone. Some of you may have noticed I haven't been uploading a lot lately, and that's because I've been busy writing a book. It's called Storm, Chasing Nature's Wildest Weather. Published by DK Books, it's loaded thick with my most beautiful storm photos, many never before seen. Shot from the Sonoran Desert to Tornado Alley, from Argentina to Australia, it's got thrilling storm stories and chasing tips. And I'll walk you through much of the science of how these storms work, from the birth of lightning and TLEs to supercells and tornadogenesis. The end result is an educational science book that's easy to read and a lot of fun. If you like this channel, I think you're really gonna love this book. I'll put a link in the description of where you can pre-order it.
It's coming. Crazy that all alone here. This would be kind of cool if it tornadoed now and I was the only one who saw it.
But it's going to wait for the million other people to get here.
Tornado on the ground.
Right there.
Okay. Me too. Beautiful. Look how snaky it is. Wow. I see it dancing in the field. As thin as this little tornado was, it was still strong enough to cause EF1 damage to a home and uproot several trees. Snaky robot. Crazy. All right, we gotta go catch that other one now. I think that's it. Let's go. As the next developing tornado tracked into no man's land, my plan was to get out in front of it, meet it up close on the other side. Open roads. If other storm chasers behind me are anxious to pass, I do my best to safely wave them around. This helps pass along courteous driving vibes and increases my chances of capturing viral video of their vehicles getting flung by the tornado.
Coming right over us.
Closely into the rotating storm base, you might see numerous smaller funnels and areas of weaker vorticity. It seems the supercell is corralling all this weaker positive vorticity and strengthening it by bundling it all together.
Dancing.
for Arnett. We're a few miles from town. Spinning up a debris cloud, the strengthening tornado is headed directly for the small town of Arnett, Oklahoma. Snapping power line poles and causing extensive tree damage, this tornado reached EF3 intensity as it partially debarked trees southwest of Arnett. Just before entering town, the powerful tornado suddenly dissipated. However, the storm still had one more tornado up its sleeve, and with each minute, more and more chasers began to arrive on the scene.
They're all going that way, so let's go this way.
With a tornado developing ahead, in hindsight, I probably should have gone straight here, but attempting to avoid the arriving chaser horde, I gambled the next northern road would have less traffic. In the rain and hail, I struggled to get a clean shot, and the road conditions were quickly deteriorating.
Pulled over.
By pulling over and courteously allowing other storm chasers to pass, you can monitor if they'll get stuck in the mud or not.
Got nothing. Gotta go. Damn.
Once these roads get wet, they can turn into slippery, silly putty, and gravity tries its best to pull you into the gutter, trapping you in the deeper mud.
Let's see if Jordan can get by without smashing us.
After having to backtrack, I had no choice but to join the entire late May chaser horde.
That dude's awesome.
As the storm raced away at roughly 30 miles per hour, the horde was in hot pursuit, moving roughly 2.5 miles per hour. Though the storm was done producing tornadoes, to the north, new storms were firing up and heading into Kansas, where several towns would not be as fortunate as Arnett. But that's a whole other story. Thanks for watching, everyone.